for competition, provision for information, websites, information centers, digital villages, I'll be talking about that, negotiations for regional international market access. This is very important. As you know, Kenya is a member of the East Africa Community, which brings together Uganda, Tanzania, Rwanda, Burundi, and this is a huge market. We are also members of COMESA, and this is also another huge market of about 400 people. So people doing this business are able to trade freely with reduced duties. The other areas of reform has been the issue of the single business permit. The so many licenses have been done away with. Business registration, it becomes now easier. If you want to start a company in Kenya, you can easily get the company registered. And what the government has done, the register of companies have computerized the process and network the registration of businesses. The personal identification number, this is very important. Previously, you could only do business when you have an ID card, but the government has now put in place the personal identification number. This is very important. If you are doing any business transactions, this is a must. Business taxation, this has also been there. And then we have the business regulatory reform unit, which is under the Ministry of Foreign which is under the Treasury. We also have the Kenya Investment Authority. If you have an investor who wants to go to Kenya, what you only need is to approach the Kenya Investment Authority, and they will be able to process the licensing requirements, and you are able to start your business within the shortest time period. There's also the Nairobi Stock Exchange, and I think we have undertaken quite a number of reforms within the Nairobi Stock Exchange. Now, having said that, we still have quite a number of challenges. As my colleague mentioned, we still haven't been able to eliminate poverty and hunger. And I think in the recent past, in the last few weeks, or in the last few months, you've seen that we have experienced one of the worst hunger in the recent past. The keto, and people don't had enough food. Now, I'm told now the rains have started, but still people don't have enough food. Unemployment of the youth is still a challenge. Infrastructure, we still haven't done what we need to do. And energy production becomes a major problem in the country. Now, because of that, the government has come up with what I mentioned earlier, the Vision 20. The government is going to address three critical areas. One of them is economic. The first one is to maintain, to sustain an economic growth rate of at least 10%. This one we have not been able to do that, as you know, the impact of the virus, the global economic crisis, but we are working towards that. The other one is to address the social issues, and this is to focus on ensuring a just and cohesive society, and again, addressing the political issues which are very important for the country. Now, under the Vision 2030, we have identified six key sectors. Now, the first key sector is tourism, the other one is agriculture, the other one is wholesale trade and retail trade, manufacturing, business process offshoring, and financial services. Now, under these specific sectors, the government has identified some what we are calling the flagship projects. Now, the idea of the flagship projects is projects that will drive growth in specific sectors. For example, in tourism, what the government is focusing on is to construct three resort cities. And we have identified the areas where they are going to be constructed, one in coast, south coast,